Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss about one of the most popular synchronization problem, which is nothing but dining philosopher. So there are many classical inter-process communication problem, or we can also call those problem as a classical process synchronization problem. So one of the most popular problem is dining philosopher. So in this, first I will tell you what is the concept of this problem, and later on we will discuss how to solve this problem. So this is actually, it consists of five philosophers, the total number of philosophers. So they were sitting in a circular table. So this is what actually the problem. They were sitting in a circular table. The philosopher will do only two tasks, which is nothing but they can either eat or they can think. So these two tasks will be done by the philosopher. So if any of the philosopher feels hungry, then he can use the two forks which is kept left and right side of that philosopher. So these are all the food that were available for each philosopher separately. Okay. So in the round table, so here we have two forks for each plate of food, but we don't have two forks separately for each plate of food. So we have in between the two plates we have one fork. So this is what the order of arranging the food and the fork. So if any of the philosopher feels hungry, he can eat food with the help of the fork that were available on his left and also his right side. So he has to use two forks. So, but we don't give the two forks separately for each philosopher. So, at the same time, if more than one philosopher feels hungry, so what they will do? Say, for example, this first philosopher and second philosopher at the same time they want to eat. So, but one of the fork that were will be available, isn't it? Because the first philosopher will take the left side and right side of the fork, but the second philosopher will not get the right side of the fork. He can get only the left side. So with only one fork he cannot eat. So it is actually given in some of the textbook. So it relates with the Chinese philosopher. So Chinese will eat some food only with the chopsticks. So one of the chopstick will not be enough to hold the food whatever they are trying to eat. So they need actually two chopsticks. So in the same way it is designed for this dining philosopher problem also. So instead of chopstick they have given it as a fork. So no problem. So anything you can mention, some of the textbook it is given as a chopstick, in some textbook it is given as a fork. So here this is what the problem. So how can we solve it? So we can apply the mutual exclusion concept here, because at the same time the no consequent philosopher leads to a same state, which means they cannot eat simultaneously. But say for example the first philosopher and also the fourth philosopher, they can eat simultaneously because they can get the two forks easily, because the first philosopher the two forks were available, because the fifth philosopher as well as the second philosopher are in thinking state, they are not currently eating. So first philosopher can get their two forks and they can eat. So he can eat, and as well as at the same time, if suppose fourth philosopher is also feels hungry, they can also eat. But the consequent philosopher cannot eat, both the first and second and third and fourth and fifth. So like that, consequently the philosophers whoever sitting next to one, so those two philosophers cannot eat at the same time. So this is what the concept of this problem. So how can we solve this with the help of the semaphore? So let us see. So how we can relate this problem with the process? The number of philosophers whatever we have is said to be the number of process. And how many number of states we have? So as I told, so thinking and eating are the two major tasks that will be done by the philosopher. Suppose if the philosopher wants to eat, we can change the state of thing to hungry. So if he feels hungry, then he can eat. So why we have included one more state here, that is hungry state? Because we should satisfy the mutual exclusion. So because if the first philosopher as well as the second philosopher feels hungry, one of the philosopher can change from can be changed from thinking state to eating state. Both the philosopher cannot be changed at the same time, isn't it? So we have included this hungry state in order to check whether any of the philosopher can enter into the eating state. So the philosopher, whoever wants to enter into the eating state is nothing but the critical section or the critical region, which means at the same time, only one at a time, only one philosopher can do that particular task. So this is what, in order to achieve the mutual exclusion, we have included one more state, that is what, hungry. So in this hungry means we have to check whether both the folks are available. If it is there, then we can allow any of the philosopher whoever hungry can enter into the eating state. So this is what the concept. So first, if you give the first very first solution, so if any philosopher feels hungry, he can take the left fork. So I'll just keep providing all the solutions whatever available. So he can take the left fork and wait for the right fork. Okay. So if it is the solution, so the first solution means, first solution is take the left fork, okay, and wait for right fork. Suppose if the right fork is not available, okay, if the right fork is not available, so it has been taken by some other philosopher, so he will wait. So if all the philosopher, so if we follow this particular condition, so what happens? So think all the philosopher at the same time were taken their left fork, and they are actually waiting for the second fork. So this will not happen at all. So this may rise to deadlock. This situation will lead to deadlock, right? So they even after a very long time, so any one of the philosopher cannot get the right fork at all. So that is what deadlock. Okay, this is the worst case. So if all the philosopher at the same time used the left fork, but they are actually waiting for the right fork, this will not be recovered. This particular situation will not be recovered at all. So this particular situation, which is nothing but deadlock. So this is not the proper solution. Second solution is, take the left fork. First you have to take left fork and check for the right fork. Check whether the right fork is available or not. Okay. If it is available, he can use it. Suppose if it is not available, means he should leave, he should release that left fork. He should leave the left fork if it is not available. So what happens here? So this will allow the other philosopher to take the, to use the left fork. So even though we are getting one of the problem in the second solution, which means if all the philosopher taken the left, so again we are thinking in worst case, at the same time if all the philosopher taken the left fork and they are checking for the right fork, so this will also be not there, right? So the right fork will not be available, so they will leave the left fork, and after again after some time, again all the philosophers will take the left fork and they will wait for the right fork. I mean, they will not wait, they will check for the right fork, but obviously right fork will not be available, so they will leave the left fork. So this particular situation will lead to starvation. We don't know when this will be happen. Only thing, if all the philosophers will not performing this same task at the same time, then we can get the solution, right? Able to understand? Suppose if all the philosophers is not performing this particular task at the same time, so only the second and fourth philosopher is performing it, so at that time he can able to use both the forks, right? So I'm just telling only in the worst case, this particular situation will also not set to be the perfect solution, because it will lead to the starvation. The first solution will lead to deadlock, so the next one will lead to starvation. So this will not be the perfect solution. Then what about the obvious solution for this problem? So we will see. So try to understand what is the concept of the problem, and so how we are going to achieve the semaphore. So we are going to implement the semaphore concept to get the perfect solution for this dining philosophy. So we'll see in the next video. Thank you.